Incremental Readings. Yes, you read the title of this video. And it's not clickbait. It's actually true. It's nothing new. It's nothing new. I am incrementally quitting SuperMemo. Incrementally moving on SuperMemo. But let me explain this. Because there's a big nuisance to explain here. So what I did at the very beginning is let me use SuperMemo for everything. Even I wanted to convert my Yankee cards in SuperMemo. That turned out that was not a good choice because of the node card relationship that I relied on and many other things. So first thing is, you know what? Let me use SuperMemo for incremental reading, but not language learning. So language learning is taking out. It's deal breaker. Sayonara. I'm not going to use SuperMemo for this. Later, you know what? Image occlusion. Not worth it. Not even with the image occlusion editor from Alexis, the unofficial way to do occlusions in Anki. Nope. It's good that you have these relationships with a image concept member, and you can go neural, and you have this semantic connection that you don't have in Anki, but it's a deal breaker. No way. And even though I don't have that many, I don't require image occlusion that often. It's anecdotal for me. So if this is in Anki and I am late into the review, I don't care. If I have a different algorithm, I don't care because I have a few hundred. So I had thousands before, but now I only have a few hundred. So it's not a big deal. Then for writing, I had the collection. For writing, then let's lose the slides, but it's so crude, the experience, that yes, I can do incremental writing because I have the scheduling. I can postpone, see this in different days, and have the incrementalism and build something incrementally. And that is one of the reasons that's why I'm not writing that much. So long story short, is deal breaker. No. I'm going to use personal knowledge management, even if I don't have the scheduling or something else, but I'm not going to use incremental writing. Then videos, that now works again with SuperMemo 19. Not in this computer, by the way, this potato PC I'm recording on. But the experience, it's to, let's say, potato experience, to rudimentary. Too many bugs. When I extract a template, it's not doesn't add up. I have to rely on so many tricks. It adds friction. Dinner today, okay. And I rely on the watch later. Lists, and that's it. So, no language learning, no image occlusion, no writing, no videos. Then, more recently, is the formal sciences. I'm not using those. What I have about math, and logic, let's postpone it, let's do with other stuff before so I have more time, so I get more used to SuperMemo or to use the LaTeX hacky solutions. Nah, deal breaker. And that's different because everything else, I have a workaround. Image occlusion, Anki. Language learning, Anki as well. Writing, I use Notion, for instance, for my channel. The MBA, all of that, I use Notion. For videos, I rely purely on YouTube playlists and the memory that, you have watched part of this video, the red line that you see. But formal sciences, namely math and logic, I don't. I have pending to try other tools like RemNote, but something that what I tried is Obsidian with the spatial repetition add-on, but no, it's not something I can use. So, I must deleted this from my collection. I only kept what is more... So the fact is that as time... Now going back, that's a massive intro, by the way. Going back to the title of this video, is that every time I use SuperMemo for less and less things, I'm taking out domains or use cases. That's why, as a consequence, I can further simplify my approach. Why now I only use two templates? One for topics, one for items. Well, I don't have image occlusions, which requires a template. I don't do videos. I don't have the YouTube or local video template. And so on. So I still rely on SuperMemo for the sake of incremental reading, because nothing else is implementing incremental reading. Even if they say, yes, that's an incremental reading app, or it has a functionality of incremental reading, it's not. There are no priorities, or the priorities are just like some buckets. High, low, mid, and stuff like this. That's not a priority queue. A priority queue is every single element in your collection has a position. No one is in the same place. And without going to details. So, I'm not moving on from SuperMemo because I cannot. I'm trapped in the sense that there's nothing else available. Not something better. Something else that implements incremental reading. So I'm hooked. I know that I will be using incremental reading. Or the next top-notch thing. With AI or virtual reality, whatever that may be, that is even better. But the point is this. That I use incremental reading. And I will continue to do so until the day I die. What I'm not so sure is if I will keep using SuperMemo as my tool of choice for incremental reading. As time goes, and there are other tools. Hey, you know what? Language learning, I will be using this. Hey, for writing, I will do this. Hey, for formal sciences, because it requires LaTeX, formulae, and all of that, I will be using this. So it's not a decision that, you know what, from today, like many people in the community, I'm done. I move on. And I either change the tool or move on, like some other people that completely move on. They don't do incremental reading, spaced repetition, or flashcards at all. Like absolutely zero. No, that is not going to happen to me. But what they don't discard is using SuperMemo. Stop using SuperMemo. So I am immensely grateful from Piotr Wozniak to create this tool. Not just the tool, but the paradigm of incremental reading. I will never in my life return this, the positive effect that had in my life. I could say that in January 2020 was my second birthday. I was reborn. It's a different paradigm. It's relearning. After suffering so much from the school system, doing different master degrees, bachelor degrees, I'm someone else that I would have been. I'm happier. I'm happy. So what I am today and whoever I will be in the future is something I will not have ever achieved if I will have stayed the same in the wrong paradigm, in the well-schooled paradigm. So that is immense. That doesn't mean I am attached to the tool. I may be attached to the person, Piotr Wozniak, his writings, his philosophy. I may be attached, and I am attached, to the paradigm, very profoundly to the paradigm, that I will defend it with my life. The method, incremental reading, will be the method used in free learning, but not the tool. This is agnostic to the tool. Nothing matters today, and see you incrementally.